morning guys and welcome back to my channel. I woke up this morning and I was craving a huge home-cooked breakfast. And then I opened the fridge and realized we have absolutely no food. If you've watched my latest YouTube videos, you'll know that I've been traveling around Australia doing my meetups, which means that Kurt has been by himself in the apartment, which also means the grocery shopping doesn't get done. So I was thinking, what a perfect time to film a grocery haul, and especially right now because I'm currently hashtag staff girl, and I'm pretty much on like apartment arrest. This is my third week now of not training and just taking it easy because I'm on like crazy amounts of antibiotics. Right now I'm really focusing on my diet and making every meal super colorful and getting loads of micronutrients in. So I honestly think right now my diet is like the healthiest it's ever been, filling my body with lots of antioxidants and immune boosting properties. So I'm gonna show you my fridge right now and just show you how empty it is. I knew it was gonna be bad, but if you guys know me, you'll know my fridge is always super chock-a-block full. This is so empty for our fridge. Normally it's overflowing with greens and vegetables, and we just have nothing right now. And even our fruit bowl, like our fruit bowl is just lemons. So yeah, need to do something about that. And our pantry is really full, but I am going to do a separate video of a pantry organization video. Maybe today I'll look for some jars as well. But before I go grocery shopping, I always make a list because I hate coming home and forgetting things. I normally separate it on different pages. So this first page is just like normal household things. And then on the back, I normally just write meat and vegetables because I pretty much know what we eat. But I have written some specific things here so I don't forget it. Raw turmeric and garlic, because garlic is a great antibacterial ingredient and turmeric is an anti-inflammatory, which is ideal if you have an infection like myself right now. And then a bunch of fruit. So I'm just going to make sure that I've got everything on there, fill out the rest, rip it off, and then head to the shops. Am I the only one who loves driving? I feel like it's like my own personal nightclub.
Yep.
Very bad.
Yo, I got a fake ID though.
Yeah. Before I go get all my groceries and like cold food, I thought I would quickly look for jars. And look, I found these, they're perfect and they're only $6 each. This can be for like my rice, my pasta, my almond meal, put my protein powder and nuts and seeds in there. Do you even jar? I'm gonna get two of the plastic ones, one for my muesli bars, like one for my blue dinosaur bars. Whoopsie. And I'm gonna get one of these to put all of our chips and crackers in. I really should have got a trolley. Look at all the stuff I got, but in this vlog I won't do the pantry organization haul. I'll save that for another video. It's gonna be so organized. Today I'm gonna get my main stuff and my meat from like Woolworths, and then my fruit and vegetables from a fruit and vegetable store. I think I'm gonna have to swap trolleys to like a big trolley because I'm gonna go home with a lot of stuff. Both Kurt and I love blueberries. We literally polish off like a punnet every single night. I've got some strawberries. Obviously going to grab my favorite fruit. I'm obsessed with bananas. And then they have these ones which are on sale because they're about to like go off or they're a bit too ripe. These are really good to freeze and have in smoothies for our smoothie bowls. And I also love to make ice cream out of it as well. I literally get so happy in the fruit and vegetable store. Like it's so colorful and happy. I think I'm going to grab some limes because I mentioned in a previous vlog that I love lemons to have like in my warm lemon water on top of salads, but I also love limes to cook with because I feel like they're a little bit more citrusy. What else can I grab? I've actually been loving apples lately, which is really random, but since increasing my starchy carbs, I've just integrated a lot more fruit back into my diet. There was one staple ingredient in our household. It's definitely avocados. We go through at least one of these a day. So I normally grab like four of these at a time. I'll grab like two hard ones and we wait for them to ripen, and then I'll grab two which are ready to go for like the day. And this is the section where most of our food comes from, and I'm so sad because I normally don't use these plastic things. My mum got me these little reusable mesh bags and I forgot them. So normally I am really environmentally friendly and I don't use these, but I forgot them. I normally get like four at a time because I will usually like snack on a whole one while I'm cooking. And then the other ones I'll use in Kurt and I salads, or yeah, pretty much just like raw salads. Onto one of my favorite vegetables of all time, zucchinis. bland sort of mediocre flavor that they absorb anything you put on them. So I'll use these a lot in like zucchini pasta, 7 of those. So one thing you may have noticed by now is everything I'm buying is a whole food, it's like a real food. And that is a pretty good representation of my diet. Everything I eat is either vegetables, fruit, meat, eggs, seeds, and nuts. I do eat a paleo-based diet. If I'm craving something like quinoa, I will eat it. That's why I call myself paleo-based. I don't just say I'm paleo. But I want to show you something that I think is really important if you are trying to start a healthy lifestyle and you don't want boring food. And that is this section right here, the herbs. So I use a lot of coriander in my raw salads. I'll use mint in my drinks. Another good one is, where is it? Basil. And this is a lot of people's favorite, especially if you love tomato-based things or like Italian food. I love to cook with basil because it's such a strong herb. I literally go through like 2 bunches of these a week. I know a lot of people eat broccoli, but I personally don't really like broccoli or cauliflower for that matter. However, I do like broccolini, and whenever Kurt and I talk about broccolini, people think we are like saying it wrong, or we're just like making a joke and saying broccoli in a weird way, but it's actually a different kind of vegetable. I normally get 2 bunches of these because Kurt absolutely loves it, so whenever I get it, he eats like the whole bunch in one meal. Seriously, feeding Kurt is like a full-time job. He eats so much. Okay, I'm gonna be honest for a second. I love the rocket mixed lettuce and the baby spinach, but I eat it for every single meal and I hate washing it. I usually get it from Woolworths and I usually get it in like the big bulk packages because it's already washed, ready for use. And ain't nobody got time to wash. Like, I prepare everything else. I cook all of my own meals. I don't know, I just hate washing grains. Iceberg lettuce. Kurt hates this, but I love it, and I feel like it just adds a crunch to all of my salads. Oh my gosh, I have not organized this well at all. Going to grab a fresh chunk of garlic. If I have a little bit, I'm fine, but too much, it stays in my system and makes me feel a little bit queasy. But I'm also going to get some sweet potato, and this is my main source of carb. I used to eat a really low carbohydrate diet, and I went to my naturopath and said, like, I'm not getting my period and all that stuff. Probably talking too loud in a public place, but YOLO. He told me to increase my starchy carbs. My favorite carb in the whole world, one of my favorite vegetables in the whole world, is sweet potato, so it definitely works for me. So I've been eating one whole sweet potato every single day, and Kurt also eats a whole sweet potato on top of like his rice and pasta and things like that. So I think I'm going to grab 4 and we'll get through that really, really quickly. Another thing that I've been eating a lot of, but I'm not going to get today because I have some at home, is raw beetroot, like the whole beetroots. And I've just been chopping them up into cubes and baking them in the oven in some cinnamon. And seriously guys, if you suffer with like bad digestion or like bad bowel movements, eat some beetroot, I swear by it. However, don't be alarmed when your poop is pink, your butt's not bleeding, it's just the beetroot. You're welcome.
Okay, I don't even know why brown onions exist. They're so boring to me. I love Spanish onions or red onions. I'll usually add like half of these into a lot of our meals. Red onions are also a great antibacterial, so I might grab 2. Great. Look how colorful and beautiful this is. Doesn't it make you so happy? I'm gonna grab a random tomato because I think I'm going to make paleo burgers tonight. I'm just craving a hamburger. But normally I will get the little cherry tomatoes because I like them better in my salads, but I feel like on burgers, a big slice of this will work better.
Oh yeah, probably. Yeah. Now, and my young sister Talia just called me and said that her and her friend are gonna come to my apartment for dinner, which means I'll have to just get extra meat, which is totally fine because you guys know me and I love hosting dinner parties and like having people over. And I feel like I show my love through like cooking for people and making people food. And like, I'm not a very emotional person and I never like hug my sisters or like tell them I love them. So if I make them food, they know what's up. They know they're loved. And with fish, I only like to get fish on the day that I'm gonna eat it. I don't really like to freeze my fish. I feel like it tastes better if it's fresh. But salmon is like our go-to. We love salmon. And I'm like the world's best bargain hunter, so I'll only buy meat when it's like on sale. And when it's on sale, I stock up.
And I always buy the bulk pack, and I'm sure you guys can guess why, because # I live with Kurt. And I usually always have a bunch of that cooked and ready to go in the fridge just for like snacking or for lunches. I'm also gonna buy some free range chicken thigh. I might actually grab another chicken breast because I know we're gonna go through it, so I'll grab that as well.
Ideally, I do like to get my steak from the farmer's market because it tastes so good. However, I haven't been able to get to the farmer's market. I do like to get this one. It's the grass-fed beef, and you can either get the Scotch fillet or the eye fillet. The Scotch fillet is a lot cheaper than the eye fillet, and I personally think they taste like really, really similar. So usually I will have like a steak once a week, and I just got a full blood test and my iron levels were perfecto. So I grab one with like the least amount of fat on it, which looks like that one. And then for my dinner party tonight, because I'm gonna make paleo burgers, I'm obviously going to make the patties from scratch because domestic princess. And I like to use the grass-fed beef. I think I might get two of these, and that should feed four of us. And if there's any leftovers, we know that Kurt's gonna eat it for lunch, or probably dessert, knowing him.
I mean, it'd be rude not to, right? Yes, it's like Christmas. Oh, and I also grabbed this cool plate because it's from Woolworths and I thought it looked really expensive. So let's check that they're not cracked, because ain't nothing worse than getting home and realizing that all the eggs are spoiled. Thank you.
Look, if there's one thing I haven't mastered, it's packing my trolley elegantly like that.
And that is not okay.
I love grocery shopping and I find it like so therapeutic. But I just hate the part of like putting it in my car and getting it to my apartment, because I'm like the most impatient person you will ever meet, and I hate going back and forth from the car. So I always make the mistake of like trying to do it all in one go, and then I like drop things or I like get frustrated. Oh my gosh, I forgot about these jars. If these smash on the way home, I'll probably cry. And what's the bet that today of all days I'll have to park like so far away from my apartment, because our street, it's like pretty packed. I bet you'll have to like park down on the beach. Oh my gosh, who am I? Listen how negative I am. Snap out of it, Sezzy, you're such a downer.
Yes, I got a park just outside my apartment. My luck is turning around, people. It is turning around. Okay. Lego.
So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up, because it really supports my channel. And make sure to subscribe, because I upload new videos every 3 days. I'm trying to vlog like every second video, and then every second video is going to be more like this, like either a recipe or a haul or a Q&A. Like I still need to do that Q&A with Kurt and I, but we can only do it on the weekends because he gets home really late at night and it's too dark to film. This weekend we can film that. But anyway, I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.